Friends, it is a matter of great honor for me to address this distinguished gathering of religious scholars and thinkers from across the world, representing various religions and traditions for Samvad on the theme of dialogue for peace, harmony, and security. It is a matter of great satisfaction that over the last 2 years, Samvad has grown from strength to strength. It has brought together diverse scholars and thinkers from all over the world to reflect on challenges that confront humanity today. Societies across the world are facing several questions today. How to avoid conflict? How to address a global challenge like climate change? What lessons do Asian values and democracy hold for the world? How to live in peace and harmony and secure our lives? All these questions are not only timeless and deeply philosophical, they are also relevant to our contemporary world. It is only natural that the search for answers be led by humanity's longest traditions of thought, rooted in various religions, civilizations, and multiple streams of spirituality. Friends, I'm a product of the ancient Indian tradition that firmly believes in dialogue on difficult issues. The ancient Indian concept of Tarka Shastra is founded on dialogue and debate as the model for exchange of views and avoidance of conflict. In Indian mythology, Krishna killed Kaunsa, and Prince Siddhartha, who later became Lord Buddha, saved a dog hurt by an arrow shot by his brother. Also, Lord Rama obeyed his father, while Bhakta Prahlad disobeyed his father. On the surface, this may appear contradictory, but the purpose of each action was to uphold dharma, which has sustained Indians from ancient to modern times. It is only through deep and prolonged dialogue, Samvad, that we may discover hidden synergies and resolve contradictions. Samvad is also the only way to cut through deep-rooted religious stereotypes and prejudices that often arise due to misconception and divide communities across the world and sow seeds of conflict between nations and societies. Friends, the Hindu-Buddhist philosophies also see nature and its entire creation as one whole. They advocate living in harmony with nature. If man does not nurture nature, then nature reacts in the form of climate change. Environmental laws and regulations, while essential in any modern society, afford only an inferior protection to nature. What is needed is harmonious environmental consciousness. Man must relate nature Man must revere nature, not merely consider it as a resource to be exploited. Friends, Asia, the world's most populous geography, is amazingly complex and wonderfully varied. It is also home to an incredible diversity of spiritual and philosophical traditions. As the interconnected and interdependent world of the 21st century battles a number of global challenges, from terrorism to climate change, I am confident that the solutions will be found through Asia's oldest traditions of dialogue and debate. My best wishes are with you as you discuss, deliberate, and debate many issues, both practical and philosophical, over these 2 days. I would also like to convey my heartiest congratulations to Sitagu International Buddhist Academy, Myanmar Institute of Strategic and International Studies, Vivekananda International Foundation, the Japan Foundation, and the government of Myanmar for organizing this edition of Samvad. Thank you. Namaste.